Dear Brother Archbishop Anthony Anandaraya, my dear Brother Archbishop and Bishops, dear Reverend Regional Superior of MAP Fathers, Reverend Fathers and Religious, distinguished guests, and my dear brothers and sisters in Christ. It is indeed my privilege and my joy to be with you to celebrate the historical and memorable occasion of the 125th Jubilee of the Archdiocese. During today's celebration, you take pride and credit to the fact that the Pondicherry Archdiocese is the mother of a then MAP diocese. You have come together as a community of believers, for the Lord has promised, as you heard in the first reading, to make the Jubilee sacred for you. You thank God during this Eucharistic celebration for the innumerable blessings you have received during the last 125 years of this Archdiocese. Your being together today is another sign and experience of the deep bond you share as a member of the Archdiocese of Pondicherry Cuddalore, and to experience the presence of God in your midst. As you heard in the second reading, behold, the dwelling of God is with us. He will dwell with us, and we shall be his people, and God himself will be with us. You are gathered here as one family to express the bond of trust and love among you. You have been blessed with the leaders of the church and the community, past and the present, who inspire and guide you during these 125 years, and the Archdiocese has progressed to be what it is today. Now you have come here to pray, to thank, and to receive God's abundant blessings. I am with you to pray with you on behalf of His Holiness Pope Benedict XVI, as I am his humble representative for this beautiful land, India. And I am for the church and its people in this part of India. I bring with me the best wishes of the Pope, who in his message to the Bishop of Tamil Nadu said recently, "My warm greetings go to the priests, the men and women religious, and all the lay faithful, entrusted to your pastoral care. Please assure them of my solicitude and of my prayers." I happily, at the end of this holy Eucharist, I will convey to each of you the apostolic blessing of His Holiness Pope Benedict XVI. During the 125th Jubilee of the Archdiocese, you are constantly reminded of the promise of Jesus that you heard in the Gospel. I am praying for them. I am not praying for the world, but for those whom you have given me, for they are yours. You have spent a lot of time preparing for this grand celebration of the Jubilee. Now you express your profound gratitude to God for all His benevolence and love for the past 125 years. You express your gratitude to God for the constant guidance and inspiration He has been given to everyone in this Archdiocese for the benefit of all. Today is a time for you to return to God with gratitude, in spite of your own failures, inabilities, and shortcomings. You come to God and offer everything of importance to Him. As His Holiness Pope Benedict says that despite the fact that we have nothing to give in return and we are full of faults, Jesus invites us to His table and wants to be with us. Don't be afraid. The Lord is always with us. Our coming together to offer the Eucharistic sacrifice on this Jubilee is a supreme act of gratitude to God for every effort to accomplish His will in the past 125 years. Jesus continues to pray for all of us. Holy Father, keep them in Thy name, which Thou hast given me, that they may be one, even as we are one, that we may continue the mission of the Church in Pondicherry. You continue to spread God's message. Today, you look back of 125 years ago when your forefathers received the faith from the courageous Jesuit missionaries way back in the year 1650. The faith has since grown and sustained the beginnings of the MEP Society that was established in 1776. The Archdiocese is now mother of 10 other MP dioceses. The faith received then is the call for all of you today to be testimonies, witnesses to others of the faith you have received. You have received the faith from others, and now you have to spread the faith and God's message to others. Pope Benedict clearly remind us of our duty, of our obligation to bring the good news and thus the kingdom of God to all. He says it is a duty and a mission which the widespread and the profound changes in the present day society render ever more urgent. At stake is the eternal salvation of persons. The goal and the fulfillment of human history and the universe. Animated and inspired by the Apostle of the Nations, we must realize that God has called you also to be the apostles of today. You are chosen as the people of God to proclaim the good news to all. You heard in the gospel passage today that I have manifested your name to all whom you have given me out of the world. They were yours, and you have given them to me, and they have kept your word. Christ went from place to place, spreading the message of God. Now you, as a community of believers, are called to continue that same mission of spreading God's message to all people. Your obligation is to bring people to the true light, because you are children of light. In this regard, I address especially to the priests and the religious that have the special role. Today is a very special day for all diocesan priests who serve in this archdiocese. You belong to this archdiocese and have a lifelong commitment to Pope. While speaking recently to the Indian bishop, said that one of the ways in which the communion of the Church is most clearly manifested is in the particularly important relationship that exists between you and your priest, whether diocesan or religious, who share and exercise with you the one priesthood of Christ. Together, in your diocese, you form one priestly body and one family of which you are the father. Along with the priest, the religious here who have consecrated and offered themselves totally and completely to God have a very special role to play in building the community. You are at service on God and His people. While each of you live the charisma of your congregation, you continue to be part of the Archdiocese. Your life and ministry are for well-being of the people you serve. Your presence in the Archdiocese is to foster the holistic development of all. The Pope speaks of the role of the religious when he met the Bishop of Tamil Nadu and explained the unique contribution made by all religious women and men, contemplative and active, to the mission of the Church, and because of their role as protagonists of evangelization through prayer and supplication, education, health care, charity, and other apostolates, their charisms will surely continue to strengthen the entire ecclesial community and enrich wider society. In a particular way, I wish to express the Church's appreciation of the many women religious of the Church in India. They bear witness to His Holiness, vitality, and hope. They offer countless prayers and perform innumerable good works, often hidden, but nevertheless of a great value of the upbuilding of God's kingdom. The 125 years you celebrate includes the fruits of the spiritual ministry and the service of the priests and the religious of the Archdiocese, then and now. And to you, to the lay faithful, to the families, the Christian family sustains a vibrant Church. This Jubilee year is perhaps the best occasion for you to review and renew your families. Remain united in me, and I will remain united in you, is the promise made by the Lord. Families are in great need of revival and renewal. The many challenges, the many obstacles faced by the families often upset, mislead, and disintegrate them. But any family that has God and His Word as the center and the guide will remain intact, firm, solid. That is why the Archdiocese has established many different organizations in the parishes that are aimed at building the family and the community. These programs must aim at strengthening family ties and the spiritual life of this basic cell of society. Only when the family is secure in the Lord would it be able to effectively witness to the gospel values in this daily life. The happy and united life of the family would indeed strengthen the Church, and it becomes vibrant and dynamic, alive with the support of the Catholic families. Dear brothers and sisters in Christ, dear friends, during this Mass, thank God for the blessing the Lord has showered upon everyone in the Archdiocese, and implore Him for a blessed future ahead of us. May everyone thank God for the gift of your leaders in the Church and all the leaders of the community, past and present. May Our Lady, the Immaculate Conception, patroness of the Archdiocese, continue to guide and keep every one of you under her mantle of protection. Amen.